Hello and welcome back. Now, this is not a case of deja vu. We have seen this body in this situation before. However, as you probably noticed in the last video with the paint, it didn't come out exactly how as I wanted it. I'm never going to get perfect, but it just wasn't good at all. I think I used too many different methods and it wasn't great. So what I've done is I've actually left this to soak in Dettol antiseptic, I think it's called. You know, the household antiseptic stuff in the brown bottle, overnight, and then I've scrubbed it all off with a toothbrush. It's got rid of all of the acrylic and the primer underneath, which is the AK micro primer filler. And this is what we're left with, and it's come up quite nice actually. So I went over with the toothbrush. There were some areas around on the top of the wings here, for instance, that were showing a bit of a seam line on there. So I've gone over them again with a sanding brush and sanded them all down. And actual surface is all right now. So what I need to do is get this back into primer and then we can start the paint process all over again. I have wiped it down already with some alcohol, 99% alcohol. And under here, you can see the wheel arches are still a little bit messy, but we don't need to worry about them because they're not going to be seen and it's only going to add to the effect. But I managed to not lose any real detail on there. The Dettol's made it come up quite nicely, so we can now go over it again with primer. So let me get the airbrush ready and I'll be back. So we have a primed turtle ready to go. I'm going to follow the same process as I did last time. So what I've done is I've taken the instructions here in the painting guide and I've made a photocopy of it and it is here. I've blown it up 200%, which gives me the exact same dimensions as the kit itself, which is really good and handy. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut each one of these sections out. I'm going to stick it onto some of this masking tape, but on a sheet rather than on a roll. So when that's on there, I'm going to stick it down and then I'm going to cut round here with a sharp blade and I'm essentially going to take masks of each one of these ones here. When it starts rolling over the top of the vehicle here, we're going to have to go a bit freestyle on there, I think, and do it sort of by hand and by eye. So we'll see what happens when we get to that point. So the first thing I need to do is actually paint the whole of the vehicle. And one of the most predominant colours on here is this warm sand yellow colour, which we can see all over. So that's the MIG colour here. So I'm now going to go over the whole of the vehicle with this warm sand yellow, let it all dry, and then we can get ready with a load of these stencils here to stick on. Once I've done that, what I'll do is everywhere where there is a warm sand yellow in the picture, like this one, say this bit here, is I'm going to take the cutout, which would be this one here. I'm going to cut round it, obviously with the Tamiya underneath, and then I'm going to stick it on top to mask off where it's got to be yellow. And then I'm going to go over the next colour, whatever it may be, and then follow the same process. And hopefully we should get something that looks a little better than it did last time. So fingers crossed, and we're going to give it a try again. So I'm going to get the airbrush ready. I'm going to get ready to go over it with this warm sand yellow. So join me back in a minute. So before we set off, what I've done is, in the airbrush, I'm using roughly 60% colour and 40% of Mr. Hobby levelling thinner in there to thin it down a fair bit, because I want a nice even coat in it to level off nicely. The levelling thinner will flash off and it will sort of make it a nice consistency when it goes down. So I've mixed that up in there now. So a mixture of paint. And then we can get ready now to fire the yellow on here. So I'm going to put the extractor fan on because it will stink. This time I'm using the iWater HPM2, which is a single action airbrush, and it's got a little dial on the back for me to dial out the amount of paint. So, just going to do that. And here we go. So, misty coat first. So here we are again. I've coated the body with the warm sand colour from MIG. It's come out quite nicely. There's a few little spots on here, like up here where it's got a bit sandpapery again. I don't know why, because I've used plenty of levelling thinner in there, and the rest of it seems alright. The rest of it's come out beautifully. So it must just catch and then sort of, I don't know what the word is, it's like vaporise and dry before it hits the surface. But there's not much we can do that about that now, so hey ho. So the next step is to cover up everywhere on here that we want to keep the warm sand colour. So I've got the template here, which I've blown up on top of the Tamiya paper, which is underneath. And we're looking at the moment at this side, the one with the hole in it, and obviously here. So first step is to cut out this piece here. I've even treated myself to a new blade. I could do with a matte under here of some kind. We'll use this one so I don't cut through my paper. There we go, that's better. So this one was the first one. Down to there. We don't mind if there's a bit of overhang at the bottom here. And then round here as smoothly as possible. We need to try and get round. The angles. So obviously it's quite quite flowing. It doesn't have to be perfect. And we should be through there. So take this first one. Essentially, we're going to stick him on there, like so. So obviously it's sticky back, like your favourite Blue Peter sticky back plastic. Ooh, I wish I had some fingernails for a change. What we're going to do is get him lined up on the corner. So, and just pushing down there. And I'm going to get a cotton swab and I'm going to push down all of the edges. So when we spray over it, hopefully we shouldn't get any paint going underneath. So I'm going to do this now for all of the areas which have got this sand colour on there. So we've got another piece, big piece here. So I'm going to do that one. So the same process yet again. What I am going to do is put some better glasses on so I can see. So start up here. I'm trying to get round all with one flow of the blade so we don't get any jug lines. But it's not going to be easy. And that should be the next one. Obviously it's quite time consuming, but to get it the way we want it, it's going to have to be done. So again, bring the model over. Try and find some reference points. So that's that way. It's just the little left of the latch.
And it goes up to... roughly
there somewhere. I say, I'm not going to follow this exactly to the instructions, because to be honest, they don't actually make sense on some of the views. Some of the orthographic projection views don't look right. Well, that's going to be a nice one there for the sand colour. So I'm going to go around the rest of it now from what I can see. So join me back once I've got all this done, and then we can start looking to lay down the next colour on top. So right, I'm going to get on with that now. So the first sort of stint at putting down the masking is done now. So that's the warm sand colour. Next colour I'm going to do is the light green khaki. So I need to go over all of this now and spray it with a light green khaki. And then we'll do the same process of putting over the masking on the areas we want to keep and keep moving on through step by step. Hopefully the tape is going to stick down and there's not going to be too much cleanup to be done, but hey ho, we'll see how it goes. So right, khaki green next. So this is the lightest colour now to go on. I think there's going to be too much blue on this again, but we may be doing some hand painting afterwards. We definitely have to do some hand painting to sort out some of the edges and things like that. I'm aware of that. But I think there may be a bit too much blue in here again. But we're going to give it a go and see what happens. So I've put the grey bluey colour into the airbrush. I'm just going to open it up a bit. And we'll go over it and say, it's pretty hard to see now with all the tape on here, but, well, see what happens. Unpainted surface. So here we go then. I am expecting a lot of grey on here. I don't think it's going to be perfect, but let's see what we've got. We can take it bit off by bit off. Again, if you've got any shares in Tamiya, you'd be making a lot of money off me at the moment for the amount of tape that I've used. Could be easy just doing this by hand. For these easy bits anyway. Trying to grab corners. So the paint's still quite delicate, so I don't want to be digging into it.
just hoping it comes out better than last time, so we've actually got something I can work with. I don't mind doing a bit of tidying up here and there, but the other one was just completely over the top. Those isn't too bad. Some of the lines seem quite tight and clean. The lighter colour there. There's another big piece here. Try it. Quite bright. The light colour grey is still a bit tacky, it's not 100% dry yet. So this is the end where I think there's just going to be too much grey. if there's any more. Oh, piece down here. Piece there.
Overall, that's not too bad, I don't think. Just going to have to do something with it. There is too much grey, especially up this end of the vehicle. So we're going to have to go over there. We'll do some hand painting to get some more of the camo in. But these sides, I'm quite happy with them. They look quite cool on that side. Again, just a little bit too much grey, but we'll work with that. We'll work with that. So better than last time. And yeah, looking good. Much more impressive. Much more impressed anyway. Alright, so next part of the video will be me trying to tidy this up a bit with the old hand brushes. So, there we have it. Let's see if we do a... full look round. And there we go. Okay, so now it's time for the decals. So, what I've done is, get the camera lined up. Time for the decals. I've just put some Microsol on there and I've left my decals in some water. And I could do with propping this up a little bit. I wonder if we can use this. See on that. Let's see if these are ready to go. So basically there's two decals on each side. Thank you. So next up on here is to put a varnish on or a coat on top of here to protect all of the decals and the paintwork that's on here already. We have the lines that sort of go around the outside of the camo that needs to be applied afterwards. And I'm going to be using this pen here, which is a 4 artist marker I got from my local hobby store. It writes on plastic okay, so it should go on here a bit like a Sharpie, a permanent marker. It's going to be quite intricate getting around all of the little camo areas. I'm just going to take my time and go over them gently. Now, giving myself a better chance in case something does screw up a little bit, to be able to rub this off, is I'm going to go over with a protective coat. And I'm going to be using the MRP Super Clear Matte version, because we're going to mess it up afterwards with some weathering and such. I think matte's going to be the best sort of option, because these are never going to be clean in the field. They're always going to be used and dirty, and it will just take the sort of the shine off the paint. Some of the paint's not too bad, like the yellow's okay, but the green's getting a bit shiny in places. So I've loaded up the airbrush already. I'm going to go over this now with the varnish. And there we go, I think she's all covered. Looking nice and flat and uniform over the whole vehicle. That's pretty good if you ask me. I'm liking that.